she also wrote an orchestra version, and then she wrote a two piano version. And the piece was inspired by tunes that she heard from missionaries who went to Bulgaria, and they brought back folk music. And so some of these tunes are very sad, and some of them are very happy. Some of them are about loss and occupation and war, and some of them are about love and happiness, and some of them are very dance-like. But what I love about this set is that at the end it ends in major, so I think it's a very hopeful message for the world today. So, Variations on Balkan Themes by Amy Beach. There are two sets, and we're playing both of them one after the other.
Thank you. Just a few words about the piece you're about to hear. It's called Opus 1 because it is officially my very first composition.
I had some unofficial ones, but they're too bad to put my name next to it. So this is the first one. I wrote this really 15 years ago. This is actually our second piece that we played together as a duet. The first piece that we played together as a duet you're gonna hear is the last piece of tonight's program. But I wrote it for Dr. Mortyakova and I, and it's a very basic theme and variation. And for those of you who might not be familiar with the genre, the theme represents sort of a melody at the beginning of the piece, and then it's sort of it's manipulated throughout the piece. I sort of refer to it as, you know, when you read a book or you watch a movie and you have the main character at the beginning, you kind of have a certain impression of that particular character, but then actions that character does, or, you know, instances that they're put in, change your impression about that character. So that's what the theme and variation is. That melody keeps being manipulated and changed throughout the section. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
in the second movement, maybe around the horbell in the third movement, and in the first movement you're going to hear some gamelan music influences that he heard at the